Bit of a different kind of video for me, this one, but I'm going to talk about how to learn a programming language, because I'm currently learning Rust and I was thinking about having already sort of become competent in other programming languages. I'm going to know which activities are going to help me progress and which ones are sort of not going to be the best use of my time. So what I thought I'd do is I've come up with a bit of a list. I've already posted things on social media about this, but I thought I'd make it into a video. So here is my advice on how to learn a programming language. Read and write code every day. I include weekends in that. Don't set off at a pace which is unsustainable. Just do a little bit every day. Figure out what is manageable and what you can do. But importantly, just show up every day and do a little bit at least. And someone referred to this as a month of lunches. And so just by doing a little bit each day, when you get to a certain time period after you've been doing it for a few weeks, you'll be able to look back, see where you were a few weeks ago. You'll be amazed at the amount of progress you can make just by doing a little bit every day. So probably number one tip there is to read and write code every day. Don't try to memorize anything, not a single thing, because what you want, the stuff that you'll remember, is the important stuff, and that is the knowledge. There will be things which you can go and look up on the internet, you know, little bits of code and things like that. But the important stuff, if you're doing it every day, day in, day out, your brain will automatically remember the important stuff. Don't waste time, don't waste memory trying to memorize stuff. It's just a complete waste of time. Anything which you do need to look up, you'll easily find the answer. Always code along. So if you're following a video tutorial or a blog post or something like that, just make sure you code along, because just by watching or reading, passive isn't going to help you. To get the information into your brain, you need to have your hands on the keyboard. You need to be actually sort of feeling the code and figuring out what it's doing as you're writing it. So I'd say always code along. Never just watch. Don't be passive. Only use tools which keep you productive and stay out of your way. One of the biggest mistakes I made when I first started out was using cheap tools or free tools. And I was spending more time trying to figure out why they're not working or doing what I want them to do, or struggling to install software and things like that, than actually writing code. You just want something which sits in the background. It enables you to do what you need to do, and that is to learn the programming language. So again, if you need more expensive tools, then save up. Just use tools which help you stay productive. Check your own understanding regular and often. The way I do this is if I'm like working through a tutorial and I see that a particular concept is being explained, I'll try and work ahead of the actual tutorial and see if I can figure it out before I actually get to the part of the tutorial where it provides the answer. And so if you think you're capable of doing that, then I'd always give that a go. Another thing you can do is you can drop comments into the code just to explain to yourself what you think the code is doing. Don't write notes, write code. So anything outside of reading and writing code when you're learning a programming language, you can think of it as procrastination. The way to learn a programming language is to read and write code. Look at anyone who learns a spoken language, the ones who excel, the ones that do the best, the ones who actually just practically apply it. They speak the language, they have a go. Don't get hung up on theory and principles and all that stuff when you're first starting out, because none of it's going to make sense until you've written like thousands of lines of code. There's experienced developers who still don't fully understand certain principles, but they can still do the job. They can still write code which works. And so what I'd say is ignore all that stuff. It's not going to make sense for a very long time. Just concentrate on solving problems by reading and writing code. You'll get better at solving problems by reading and writing code over time, and you'll get better at applying principles over time. But if you try and start setting off by doing that straight away, you're going to find it very hard. And also, sort of along the same theme, don't think that you have to understand everything straight away. There's going to be a lot of things which you don't understand and which you ain't going to understand fully for quite a long time. There's some things which I've learned when I've been learning programming languages which haven't made sense to me until I've actually seen them or tried to apply them 50 times or more, you know. So, like I say, don't get sort of into a position where you think that you have to understand everything straight away. It's not going to happen. My next piece of advice is to just run the code. I'm always amazed when I see learners when they follow along with the tutorial or anything really, and they'll write like 30 lines of code before checking that the first one is working. Each line of code or each couple of lines that you write, just print things out, dump things out, check that the code's doing what you expect it to be doing, and that way you're reinforcing your knowledge of the code and the language every step of the way. If you're going to write 20 or 30 lines of code and then check what's going on, you're not really going to have full control over what's happening. You're not going to have full understanding of how and why the code works. So, like I say, just run the code. And the final thing I'll say is don't do tutorials forever. Once you reach a certain point, you've got a certain amount of knowledge, that will be enough to actually go and try and solve a problem or create something. You'll be able to take what you already know and combine it with what you don't know and learn along the way. And that way you'll sort of reinforce things and also pick up a load of new knowledge, a load of new skills along the way. That's how you really learn. That's how you become independent and competent.